In this video, we will explore the internal structure of our planet, and in particular, we will discuss Earth's rheological layers, which means that we will discuss the physical characteristics of the rocks that make up our planet and how they behave when they are deformed. Let us start by dispelling a common myth. Contrary to what many believe, the interior of the Earth is not composed of magma. Indeed, almost all of the Earth is solid, with one exception, the outer core. Why is that? You may know that temperature increases as we go deeper inside the Earth. In fact, the temperature increases from approximately 15 degrees Celsius at the surface to more than 6,000 degrees at the center. But as we go deeper and deeper, pressure increases too, since there are more and more rocks weighing down. Now, pressure and temperature have an opposite effect on melting. An increase in temperature can cause rocks to melt. On the contrary, increasing the pressure makes melting more difficult. If this seems counterintuitive, consider that, usually, when something melts, it increases in volume. A greater pressure makes this increase in volume much more difficult, and therefore, it will take more energy and a greater temperature to melt something that is under pressure. So, in a sense, there is a competition between pressure to keep rocks solid and temperature to melt them. The effect of temperature outweighs the effect of pressure only in the outer core, whereas at all other depths, the enormous pressure keeps the rocks solid. However, geologists think of solids in a slightly different way than most people do. In fact, what is a solid? You have probably learned that a solid is something that keeps its shape even without a container. But let's think of peanut butter, for example. It's pretty solid, and yet it can change shape when you spread it with a knife. As it turns out, if we consider a sufficiently long period of time, say hundreds of thousands of years, and if temperature is right, the rocks too can behave like peanut butter and be deformed. In this case, we say that the rocks are ductile. Let's take a closer look. Near the surface, in the crust, and in the uppermost mantle, the temperatures are still relatively cold. You may have experienced that when a spread comes right out of the fridge, it is more difficult to spread, and therefore less ductile. So the same is true for rocks. In fact, the outer layer of the planet, called the lithosphere, contains rocks that are relatively cold and therefore quite rigid. The rocks in the lithosphere are not ductile and do not deform easily. When they do, instead of flowing, they break, forming faults. As we will see in a future video, this rigid layer known as the lithosphere is what forms the tectonic plates, which deform very little and only in specific places. As we go deeper, the temperature continues to rise, and at a depth around 100 or 120 kilometers, it reaches approximately 1200 degrees Celsius, which corresponds to the temperature at which rocks start to become more ductile. We then have a second layer called the asthenosphere. Unlike the lithosphere, in the asthenosphere, even though rocks remain solid, they are able to move in response to density, pressure, or temperature gradients. Thus, in the asthenosphere, rocks are moving around in loops in a process called mantle convection. Note that they are moving very slowly, on average a few centimeters per year. But despite this, as we will see, these movements are one of the main causes of plate tectonics. The asthenosphere stretches to a depth of approximately 600 or 700 kilometers. Below this, for the rest of the mantle, there is a relatively unknown layer, the mesosphere. Scientists believe that although convection can also be observed in the mesosphere, the rocks there are stronger than the rocks in the asthenosphere. To summarize, when we look inside our planet, in addition to the layers with different chemical composition, core, mantle, and crust, we can also recognize five rheological layers: the lithosphere, which is rigid, the asthenosphere, which is ductile, the mesosphere, the outer core, which is the only liquid layer, and finally the inner core. Thank you for your attention. Please consider subscribing if you would like to see more videos like this one. See you soon!